Good morning students, welcome to Narayana live classes. Today we are going to discuss about 8th class vectors topic, assignment number 30. So let's see the questions. First question is, if O is in equilibrium, then tensions T1 and T2 are, for that he is given that 1037 is equal to 3/4. So if we see the right angle triangle with 37 degrees and here is 53 degrees. So this is 3, this is 4 and hypotenuse is 5. So we can take the help of this triangle. And now, so if we resolve the T1 and T2, so with the help of the point O, so here the angle is given as 53 degrees. So here is also, we will have the angle 53 degrees and this is 37 degrees. So this is also 37 degrees. Now if we take the three vectors, one is the tension T1 in the first string and another one is the tension T2 in the second string and the third one is weight acting in the downward direction, that is 100 newtons about the point O. Now the total angle between T1 and T2 is already given as this is 90 degrees. And next, the total angle between T2 and 100 degrees is, this is 90 and this is 53 degrees. So this is 90 plus 53 degrees. And the total angle between the T1 and 100 newton is, this is 37 and this is 90 degrees. So this is 90 plus 37 degrees. So let's take the help of Lamy's theorem. According to the Lamy's theorem, if three unequal forces are acting about the point O and if the point O is in equilibrium, then so we can take, so first vector magnitude means T1 by sine of 90 plus 53, T2 by sine of 90 plus 37 degrees is equal to 100 by sine 90 degrees. So let's take the help of Lamy's theorem. So according to the Lamy's theorem, we will take T1 by sine of 90 plus 53 degrees so is equal to T2 by sine of 90 plus 37 degrees. Is equal to 100 newton by sine 90 degrees. If you want to find out the T1 and the T2 values, so let's equate the first term and the last term. So let us say T1 is equal to 100 by sine 90 into sine of 90 plus 53. So T1 is equal to 100 by, as we know that sine 90 value is 1 and sine 90 plus theta, so that is equal to cos theta. So this can be taken as cos 53 degrees and according to the given triangle, if you take this 53 degrees and cos 53 degrees is equal to 3/5, then by substituting cos 53 as 3/5, this is equal to 100 into, so that is 3/5, 5 gets cancelled in 100 for 20 times, that is equal to 20 into 3, 60 newtons. And similarly, if you want to find out the T2 value, then we can take T2 is equal to 100 into sine 90 plus 37, that is nothing but cos 37. And from this triangle, if you see cos 37, it is 4/5, so that is equal to 100 into 4/5, so that is equal to 80 newtons. So therefore T1 is 60 newton and T2 is 80 newton. So these are the tensions, T1 is equal to 60 newtons and T2 is equal to 80 newtons. So let's see the options. according to the given options. Second option is correct, 60 Newton and 80 Newton. So let's see the next question, students. A man of 80 kg is suspended by two cables as shown in the figure. Then, so if you see the weight, it is given in kg weight. So students, we need to remember that 1 kg weight is equal to 9.8 Newton. So whenever we take in the weight, so when we multiply with acceleration due to gravity, it will be converted into Newton. But now we have directly taken 1 kg weight, it is nothing but 9.8 Newton. So now here the angles are 60 degrees and 30 degrees, and if you take the horizontal line about the point O, if this is 30 degrees, so this is also 30 degrees, and this is 60 degrees, then this is also 60 degrees. And now we know that this is 90 degrees, and this is also 90 degrees. And if we take the three vectors, the tension T1, and another tension in the cable is T2, and the weight is acting in the downward direction, that is 80 kg weight. And let's see the total angles between the vectors. The angle between T1 and T2 is 90 degrees. And here the angle between T2 and 80 kg weight, this total angle is 90 plus 30 degrees. And the total angle between T1 and 80 kg weight is 90 plus 60 degrees. Now if we apply the Lamy's theorem, according to the Lamy's theorem, we can take T1 by sine of 90 degrees plus 30 is equal to T2 by sine of 90 plus 60 is equal to 80 kg weight by sine 90 degrees. So now if you want to find out the T1 and T2 values, let's equate the first term and the last term. So if you equate the first term and last term, then we will get T1 is equal to 80 kg weight by sine 90 into, so this is 90 plus 30, sine of 90 plus 30 degrees. So this is equal to 80 by sine 90 value is 1. Sine 90 plus 30 means that is cos 30 degrees. So that is equal to 80 into, we know that cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So let's take the values. So we will get T1 is equal to 40 root 3 kg weight. Now if we equate the second term and the third term, so the second term is T2 by sine 90 plus 60, and the third term is 80 by sine 90. Now T2 is equal to, so this is 80 by sine 90 value is 1 into sine 90 plus 60, that is nothing but cos 60. So T2 is equal to 80 into cos 60 value is 1 by 2. Now we will get the T2 value as, so T2 is equal to 40 kg weight. So the tensions in the cable, T1 is equal to 40 root 3 kg weight, and T2 is equal to 40 kg weight. So let's see the options. So T1 is equal to 40 root 3 kg weight, and T2 is equal to 40 kg weight. So both options are correct, options 1 comma 2 for question number 2. And let's see the third question. So if we see the third question, if P is in equilibrium, then T1 by T2 is, if P is in equilibrium, so here the angle is 60 degrees and here it is 30 degrees, then we know that the angle between T1 and T2 is equal to 90 degrees. So this angle is equal to 90 degrees and this angle is also equals to 90 degrees. According to the Lamy's theorem, if we take T1 by sine of, the total opposite angle is sine of 90 plus 60 degrees is equal to T2 by the total opposite angle is sine of 90 plus 30 degrees is equal to, the weight is 900 Newton, so 900 by sine of 90 degrees. Now, if you want to find out the ratio of T1 by T2, so let's exchange the terms between the T1 and the T2. So if we take T1 by T2, T1 by T2 is equal to sine of 90 plus 60 by sine of 90 plus 30. So as we know that sine 90 plus 60 is cos 60 and sine 90 plus 30 is cos 30. So cos 60 value is 1 by 2 and cos 30 value is root 3 by 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled. So T1 by T2 we will get it as 1:√3. So therefore the ratio of both the tensions T1 and T2 is equal to 1:√3. So let's see the options. So 1 by root 3, third option is correct. Thank you.